My family is me and my wife Courtney, and we have 5 kids: Madison, Chloe, Zachary, Noah, and Brooklyn. They drive me crazy just about every day. We're a family of extremes, I guess. We're extremely happy and extremely affectionate. They're everything. They're why I'm here. God put me here to lead them and to love them, and they make me happy, they make me sad, they make me everything. They're my family. About 3 years ago, I almost lost it all. When I was growing up, I didn't have a role model. I had a series of stepdads. They weren't the best stepdads to begin with. So when we put this family together, I didn't know how to lead this family or how to be the role model for my boys, protector for my girls, even for my wife. My first marriage, I got married when I was 20. It was a disaster from the start. I didn't know what I was doing. I was a horrible leader. I was impatient and unkind, just immature. I had no wisdom, and it went south quickly. When Courtney and I got married, I thought it was gonna be different. At the time, I pushed a lot of blame on other people and didn't accept a whole lot of responsibility for what happened the first time around. And so I automatically thought that things would be different with Courtney. I was so caught up in me and so caught up in what was important to me. I made a promise to Courtney when we got married. I made a promise to the kids when we got married. And all of that went out the window. None of it mattered. It was all about me. But I was so convinced that there was no way I could be happy in this marriage. There was a lot of times when Courtney was praying for me, praying for our family. And I was stubborn and depressed and far from God. And it seemed like, to her, God had abandoned our family. Well, about 3 years ago, things finally came to a head. Things blew up in our family. Courtney and I had been going to counseling on our own, counseling together for over a year or a year and a half. Nothing worked. Nothing got better. Just constant fighting, constant destruction. I convinced myself that it was everybody else. It was all their fault. I convinced myself that I'd be happier by myself. And I was in this fog. All I knew is that if I could just get away, run away from this family, that I would be happy. After I told Courtney that I wanted a divorce, I told her that she needed to leave. I told her that she needed to leave and she needed to take her kids with her. I told her I didn't want to do this anymore. I told her she'd be better off back home in California with her family. And so that's what she did, and she left. We are right to fall. Seems like a few days after she left, I broke. I couldn't stop crying. Everywhere I went, if I was at work, if I was in the car, if I was at the grocery store, I just break down crying. I was just weeping nonstop. I was just miserable. And I didn't know what it was, but looking back, it was God breaking down the walls. I had to be humbled before I could be anything else. And one night, everything changed. I can remember it like it happened yesterday. I was alone in the house, and I just felt like this force or this weight on my shoulders that just pushed me to the floor. I was on my knees next to one of my kids' beds, just weeping my eyes out, just crying. That's when God intervened. Here I am, an atheist, talking to a God I don't believe in. I just started praying, God, if you're real, if you're there, I can feel you. I begged for him to just take over, that I couldn't do this. I was at the end of my rope, everything was gone, and I needed him. It took a lot of work being so far apart to repair what was so broken, but Courtney was willing to do it, and it was all I wanted to do, was to put our family back together. I did the only thing I knew how to do. I went to church. I went to GCC. I talked to Courtney every day. I started reading my Bible every day. And eventually, a year later, I drove to California. I packed up my family and I brought them home. It's funny, you can't have a family with a little bit of Jesus and expect it to work. You have to have a lot of Jesus with your family. And all the counseling in the world, all the books and advice, it doesn't mean anything until you have God at the center of your marriage, at the center of your family. It was the only thing that could repair what we'd broken so badly. Well, the culmination of this journey, and really the beginning of a new chapter in this journey, was baptism. It was the natural next step, and it was awesome.